Yes, good morning all of you. Today we will discuss the question answers of the chemical effects of electric current, right? We completed this chapter and today we will discuss the question answers of this chapter. Let's start with this. Blanks are there. Most liquids that conduct electricity are solutions of dash dash and dash as Gia. Solutions of acids, bases and salts, right? Because acids, they have free ions, bases have free ions, salts when dissociate, it releases the free ions. So the solution that conduct electricity are acids, bases and salts. Second blank is there. The passage of an electric current through a solution causes dash effect. Don't give together, like I will ask you. Third, if you pass current through a copper sulfate solution, copper gets deposited on the plate connected to the dash terminal of the battery. Yes, Gopal. Because copper ka kya hai? Copper, the bache, copper gets deposited on the connected to the dash terminal of the battery. Negative, because copper itself positive and it will give the sodium positive. Copper sulfate, copper chloride, okay, sodium chloride, sodium sulfate. So sodium, the first one is positive and the second one is negative. Yes, the next is the process of, yes, Gurshan, unmute yourself. The process of depositing a layer of any desired metal.
Electroplating.
Electroplating. Who will give the definition of electroplating? What do you mean by yes, Hirde? The process of depositing a thin layer of superior metal or other metal on the metal surface with the help of electricity, that is called the electroplating. Next is, when the free ends of the tester are dipped into a solution, the magnetic needle show deflection. Can you explain the reason? Yes, Titiksha, unmute yourself.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
When the electric current passes through it, the needle of compass deflect because it behaves like a magnet, and when the current pass through it, it is made up of metal. So due to passage of electric current, it deflects.
We can write down like what we will write. The compass needle show deflection, which concludes that the current is flowing through the circuit. If the deflection is there in the magnetic compass, that means the current is flowing through the circuit. And the circuit complete as the free ends of the testers are dipped into the solution. That's why magnetic compass shows the deflection. Is it clear? Hanji, good. Next, wait. Name the liquid which when tested in the manner may cause magnetic needle to deflect. Anything we can write, salt water, tap water, vinegar, lemon juice, right? HCl, sodium hydroxide, anything we can write.
Koi baat.
NaCl, yes, salt.
Koi baat. Cut kar do. Copy le le, likh le jo main kar raha the. Roti bhi kha le saath saath.
The bulb does not glow in the setup shown in the figure. List the possible reason and explain the answer. I'm just making it and tell me, as we already discussed, what are the basic reasons that the bulb will not glow? Yes, anyone from the class? When the bulb does not glow? 1 second.
The
Yes. And dipped in the solution. Apparatus is okay. Then why the bulb will not glow? Okay. Number one reason, what are the basic reason if the bulb will not glow, if the circuit is totally complete? What are the reason behind it? Maybe this is non-electrolyte, right? Maybe this is glucose, the bulb will not glow. Maybe switch is not properly, circuit is not complete, or circuit is not set up properly, bulb may be fused. Again, number of the reasons is already, battery is not working. Right? Okay, terminals, wrong terminals will be connected, but here the terminals are okay, so we will not write. Here what we can write, maybe the bulb may be fused, non-electrolyte, circuit is like not set up properly, battery or the cell is fused. Yes, Jia Janvi, unmute yourself. One other reason also. Maybe the current is very weak or the low voltage, as we already had discussed. That's why we use the LED. Bulb will not glow. If the current is too weak or the voltage is low, when at that time bulb is not glow. So another reason is also this. Next question. A tester is used to check the conduction of electricity through two liquids, label A and B, right? It is found that the bulb of the testers glows brightly for the liquid A, while it glows very dimly for the liquid B. You conclude that liquid A is a good conductor or a B? Yes.
Liquid A is a good conductor. Because the bulb glows very brightly in that case.
Yes, Navedita, unmute yourself.
The current passes through it completely.
We conclude that liquid A is better conductor than liquid B.
That means the conductivity of the solution through the A solution, through the solution A, yeah, might be good, or we can say through greater the conductivity, greater the shine, like the bulb glows brightly. As we already discussed when we were doing experiment, at that time we also observed that when we are dipping, so sometime it glows very brightly, but if we are using the dilute acid, the bulb will glow dim. Next question. Does pure water conduct electricity? If not, what can we do to make it conducting? Yes, Dharia. Again, is it clear? Pure water does not conduct electricity because it has, it will not dissociate into free ions, or it has no free ions, right? It has no free ions. Yeah, no free ions are present in the pure water. To make it conducting, we will add some salt in it so that free ions will be there and the current will be passed. Okay, ji? Next is, in case of a fire, before the firemen use the water hoses, they shut off the main electrical supply for the area. Explain why they do so. Karanveer, unmute yourself. Deep Kirti, unmute yourself. Deep Kirti, Anji.
We can add salt in water.
Karan, next question.
Ma'am.
Anji.
Ma'am, water usually contains salts and conduct electricity. If the electrical supply is cut off and firemen come in the contact with the wet electric switches, electric wires and the other electric appliances, he can get electric shock.
He can get the electrical shock because water is a good conductor of electricity. And if he will not switch off the main switch, then he will get the current will pass through the water and he will get the shock. Next is, a child a child staying in a coastal region tests the drinking water and also the sea water with his tester. He finds that the compass needle deflect more in case of the sea water. Can you explain the reason? Bolo. It has more amount of free ions or the salts. Salts are present in the sea water is more as compared to the pure water, drinking water. So the sea water will be better conductor than the drinking water. It increase the deflection of the magnetic compass. Yes, magnetic compass is a that kind of a tester that will work on a very, very low voltage. If there will be current, LED has very slow, but agar in any case, if the current is there, the needle will deflect. As we have seen the bar magnet, as we will bring it to it, automatically attract, right? Small jo circular magnets you are using, and when you will bring it near to the TV, what happen? Colors fluctuate hote. That means, is it safe for the electrician to carry out electrical repair outdoor during heavy rain downpour? Why? Yeah, explain. Idhar se pooch lene do ek minute. Yes, Manyavit, unmute yourself. Manyavit, unmute yourself.
Yes, ma'am. No, it is not safe to repair electrical appliances outdoors during a heavy downpour because rainwater is composed of certain percentage of dissolved salts, which makes it a conductor. This may cause electric shocks and harm the electricians while working outdoors during heavy rainfall.
Or any doubt? Is it clear? Lavanya, Jia, Ritika, clear? Okay, next question. Paheli had heard that rainwater is a good as distilled water, so she collected the rainwater in a clean glass tumbler and tested it using a tester. To her surprise, she found that compass needle showed deflection. What could be the reason? Bolo Darya. Do you know the rainwater is the purest form of water? How? If acid rain occur, na, if it is not occurring, then rainwater is the purest form. Rainwater, although rainwater is the purest form of water, but when it will come in contact, enters into our atmosphere, like when it comes near to the earth, it has many salts in it because the salts are present and it mixes with those salts and make it conductive. Actually, the rainwater is the purest form, but when it enters into the earth surface, so impurities added in that rainwater to make it a impure. That's why the impurities or the salts are present. Okay, ji. Sorry. Prepare a list of objects around you that are electroplated. Chromium plating on the outdoors like that, automobiles, okay? Right, gold plating, ornaments, zinc plating where we will use, or why zinc is plating?
To protect them from corrosion and rusting.
To protect from corrosion, like to resist from the corrode. We are, as we discussed that these are the, why we are doing the electroplating, to make it a decoration purpose or make it protected, like to protect it from the corrosion. Right? Next is, the process that you saw in the activity is used for purification of copper. A thin plate of pure copper and a thick rod of impure copper are used as electrodes. Copper from impure rod is sought to be transferred to the thin copper plate. Which electrode attached should be attached to the positive terminal of the battery and why? Yesterday we had done this. When we are doing the electroplating, so where we will put that rod which will melt or which will release its ion into the solution? Anode. That means a positive terminal. So what we will write down the answer. Prabhjot, unmute yourself. Prabhjot, okay, now anyone from the class? Hanji?
Yes, ma'am.
Wait a while, ek minute. Hanji, bolo.
Ma'am, question repeat karna.
Which rod should be attached to the positive terminal when we are doing the experiment with the copper, like impure rod or pure rod?
Ma'am, anode.
Give the exact answer.
Ma'am, pure.
Anyhow, wait a while. Yes, Rupal.
Ma'am.
We will write down, note it down. Ma'am. The thick rod of impure copper plate is attached to the positive terminal. The thick rod of impure copper is attached to the...
Ma'am, copper is me impure.
Kya?
Ma'am, is me copper impure ko kaha gaya hai? Ma'am, copper ko impure.
We will use it na, the rod impure, that rod. Note it down and after that I will again ask you ki clear or not. The thick rod of impure copper plate is attached to the positive terminal of the battery because when electric current is passed through the copper sulfate solution, as we had discussed, if we will take this copper sulfate and if we will make this impure rod, like, right? So what will happen? Write down. When electric current is passed through copper sulfate solution, it dissociates into, as yesterday we discussed, it dissociates into copper 2 positive. Write down like this. Copper 2 positive and SO4 2 negative ions. It dissociates, copper sulfate dissociates into Cu2 positive and SO42 negative ions. Or you can simply, you can also write that it dissociates into copper and sulfate ions. The copper, next line, the free copper. We discussed na beta, the free copper being positive, it will attract towards the negative electrode. Write down, the free copper being positively charged move towards the negative terminal of the battery. Move towards the negative terminal of the battery. And loss of copper from this solution is restored from the impure copper rod. road. That means when this copper sulfate, look here, when this copper sulfate, it dissociate, it will give you copper and sulfate ions. Being positive copper, it will move towards the negative side. And what will happen to the positive side? This is all loss of the copper from the solution occur. It is restored by the copper releasing by this. That's why we are using this impure copper to just to balance the solution so that the ions will remain the balanced in it. Is it clear? Next, hair question? Completed? Any doubt to anyone, then please ask. Right now, all of you will note it down in your notebook.